Hi, Summit kiddos, Miss Heather here. I love, love, love that you're watching Kids Church at home. Good job. So friends, this week we're talking about how I can do big things for God. Guess what? It's prop talk time. And today for our prop talk, I have a very big weight. It's very, very heavy. And did you know that, okay, I can probably do one curl. Oh, maybe one press. No, it's too heavy. But guess what? If I work out with smaller weights first, lighter weights, then someday I'll be able to pick up that heavy weight because my muscles will get stronger and do it. So if I practice and I exercise, I will keep getting stronger and stronger, and so can you. That reminds me of our how can I do big things for God question. If you want to do big things for God, you have to obey in the little things. Obey more each day, and then you'll be able to do big things for God. So friends, when you see a big heavy weight, I want you to think that if you can do little things for God, you'll be trusted to do big things for God. So friends, it's time for our movie and music to go on a Bible adventure with Emily to ask the question, how can I do big things for God?
On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I want to know that God is real. I want to know how I could be his friend. I want to know who Jesus is. I want to find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! On a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do. On a Bible adventure. Church is a fun place we can go on a Bible adventure.
One, two, three. Oh, hi friends! I was just exercising so I can be strong for our Bible adventure. Shake your hands high in the sky if you want to go with me. Woohoo!
Wee! Hi, Emily. Good to see you, friends.
Shine, we're just getting ready for our Bible adventure.
What question are you trying to answer today?
It's a tough one. How can I do big stuff for God?
Hey, I know some picture passes that'll help you find the answer.
Sweet sassy molassie! I was hoping you'd say that! Now friends, put on your adventure bag with me! Now we can be picture pass guessers together!
The first picture pass shows you're really strong!
Which one is it, friends? It is the muscle. The muscle shows us we're really strong.
Friends, pretend to catch it in your adventure bag.
I caught it, Shine. Now what's next?
Well, a baby drinks from this one.
A baby? Which one is it, friends? It is the bottle.
Get your adventure bag ready. Catch that bottle.
We caught it, Shine. Now, what's the last picture pass?
This one shows a little job I can do when I'm done playing with my toys.
A job? Which one is it, friends?
The toy box reminds me of cleaning. It must be a clean-up picture pass.
That's right. Friends, pretend to catch it in your adventure bag.
Friends, count them with me.
One, two,
three. They're all here. Now let's zip our adventure bag together. Now it's time to fly!
Whoa!
Shine, do you think exercising will help me do big stuff for God?
Exercise makes your body grow strong, but it doesn't show you're ready to do big stuff for God.
Huh? Well, why not?
We can find out in the Bible.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
A baby and a bush. That Bible story's from the book of Exodus. It's about Moses and his sister.
Let's watch it and see if they got to do big stuff for God.
Egypt was filled with Israelites. The new Pharaoh was afraid that the Israelites would become too powerful. So he made them slaves and treated them very badly. Pharaoh ordered that all baby Israelite boys had to be killed. One woman put her baby in a basket and hid him by the river's edge. His sister watched him. Pharaoh's daughter was bathing by the river. She found the baby and decided to keep him. His sister offered their mother's help to care for him. Pharaoh's daughter named him Moses. Moses grew up. One day, he saw an Egyptian beating an Israelite. Moses killed the Egyptian. Then he fled to Midian and was a shepherd for 40 years. Moses was watching his sheep on Mount Horeb. The voice of God spoke from a burning bush. "My people are suffering, Moses. I have chosen you to free them." "I can't," Moses cried. "I'll help you," God promised. "Throw down your staff." Moses did. It turned into a snake. When he picked it up, it was a staff again. "Put your hand in your cloak," God said. Moses did. He looked. It was covered with disease. When he did it again, it was healed. "Show Pharaoh that," God said. "I'm not a good speaker," said Moses. "I'll give you the words," God said. "Your brother Aaron can help." So Moses went to tell Pharaoh to set the Israelites free.
Muffins and meatballs! God sent Moses to save the people from Egypt's mean Pharaoh.
But Moses had to wait a really long time to do that big stuff for God.
That's because Moses made some wrong choices. But Moses' sister was different.
Yeah, her mom trusted her to take care of Moses, even though she was still a kid.
Kids can do big stuff for God.
That's right. When you obey little things each day, you show you're strong for God.
And God trusts you to do big stuff for Him. I think we can answer the question now.
Okay. How can I do big stuff for God?
I obey God more each day.
Wee! I'm gonna go talk to Blinky about that. See ya, Emily!
Bye, Shine! Come on! Hi, Guy.
Hey, Emily. What's your Bible adventure about today?
We're trying to find the answer to the question, how can I do big stuff for God?
I obey God more each day. That's why I'm always reading my Bible.
How does that help you obey and do big stuff for God?
Learning from my Bible is something I can do each day to show I'm strong for God.
And then you can do big stuff for God, like Moses and his sister.
Exactly. Do you have a picture pass about that?
Maybe I do. Friends, which picture pass shows you're really strong? It's the muscle. The muscle reminds me to grow strong for God.
But you've got to start by obeying little stuff each day.
Guy, do you have a Bible verse about that?
Of course I do. Friends, wiggle your ears if you're ready to say the verse with me.
I'm wiggling my ears. Are you wiggling yours?
Great. Okay. Luke 16:10. Whoever can be trusted with very little can also be trusted with much. Whoa!
Guy, my friends and I want to try it too.
Okay, repeat after me. Luke 16:10.
Luke 16:10.
Whoever
can be trusted
with very little
can also be trusted
with much. Whoa!
With much. Whoa!
Friends, I think we've got it. Now let's try the whole verse together.
Luke 16:10. Whoever can be trusted
with very little can also be trusted
with much.
Whoa!
Cartwheeling kittens! That verse shows us to be strong for God!
Yeah! When you obey little stuff, God can trust you to do big stuff!
Thanks for teaching us that verse, Guy.
Sure thing!
Bye, Guy!
Bye, Emily! Bye, friends!
I'm so strong! Whoa! Look at this mess! We need to clean up! No way! That's little stuff! I only do big stuff, like running the vacuum cleaner! Friends, do you think Blinky should clean up? Shine! What do friends say I need to do this little job? If you won't help with little stuff, no one will trust you to do the big stuff. But Shine, I'm no baby bug. I'm super-de-duper strong. That shows I'm ready for the big stuff. A big, strong body isn't what you need to do big stuff. Even little bugs can do big stuff for God. Well, I asked Jesus to live in me. He's my leader and my best friend. That's great, Blinky. Jesus will never leave you. But you still need to grow strong for God. How am I gonna do that? Obey the little stuff each day. Then you can be trusted with the big stuff. I'm gonna have to pray about that. 'Cause I don't really like doing the little stuff. God, please help me obey the little stuff each day so I can grow strong for you. In Jesus' name, amen. So, what do you think, Blinky? Should we do this little job? You betcha. Cleaning up is a little job I can obey to show I'm ready for the big stuff. Your mom might even ask you to run the vacuum cleaner when we're all finished. Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy!
Hi, friends. Say the Bible verse with me. Luke 16:10. Whoever can be trusted with very little, can also be trusted with with much.
Hua!
The muscle reminds me of Moses' sister from the Bible. She did big stuff for God. I bet she grew strong for God by obeying the little things each day. Her mom trusted her to take care of Moses when he was a little baby. Taking care of a baby is big stuff. Friends, pretend to take care of a baby with me. We're in race cars. What's going on in Mr. Music's singing studio? Let's go find out. Come on, friends. Mr. Music, is there a baby in here?
Oh no, I was just practicing a funny part of a song I like.
Oh, I know what a baby needs when it's crying.
Friends, which picture pass is something babies drink from?
It's the bottle! Mr. Music, do you need a bottle?
No way. I'm not a baby anymore. Babies can't even obey the little stuff.
Yeah, so they really aren't strong enough to do the big stuff for God. Hey, that reminds me of our question. How can I do big stuff for God?
Say it with me. I obey God more each day.
Yeah! Oh, Mr. Music, do you have a song about that?
I sure do. Friends, clap your hands together if you'd like to sing it with me.
I'm clapping my hands. Are you clapping yours?
Okay, I'm gonna teach you the funny part first. When I sing I'm Not a Baby, you cry like a baby and go wham wham.
Okay? Okay.
Let's try it. I'm not a baby.
Wah!
I'm not a baby.
Wah, wah.
That was great. Now repeat after me. I can do big stuff for God.
I can do big stuff for God.
Yeah. Now let's sing the whole song together.
Okay, friends, sing with me.
Here we go. Whatever I say.
Whatever I say.
Whatever I do.
Whatever I do.
I obey God more each day.
I obey God more each day.
Yeah. Whenever I'm home.
Whenever I'm home.
Wherever I go.
Wherever I go.
I obey God more each day.
I obey God more each day.
One, two, three. I'm not a baby.
Wah, wah.
I'm not a baby.
Wah, wah.
I can do big stuff for God.
I can do big stuff for God.
I'm not a baby.
Wah, wah.
I'm not a baby.
Wah.
I can do big stuff for God.
I can do big stuff for God.
Isn't that fun?
I love it.
Whatever I say.
Whatever I say.
Whatever I do.
Whatever I do.
I obey God more each day.
I obey God more each day.
Yeah. Whenever I'm home.
Whenever I'm home.
Wherever I go.
Wherever I go.
I obey God more each day.
I obey God more each day.
One, two, three. I'm not a baby.
Wah, wah.
I'm not a baby.
Wah, wah.
I can do big stuff for God.
I can do big stuff for God.
I'm not a baby.
Wah, wah.
I'm not a baby.
Wah, wah.
It's a big thing to obey. And I obey God more each day.
That's how I know I can do big stuff for God.
That was great! Now stand to your feet to worship God with music, singing, and dancing.
You made my ears.
One, two.
So I can listen. You made my eyes.
One, two.
So I can see. So I can praise you. You made my heart so.
Shine, how's Blinky?
He's stronger than ever. Did you find the answer to the question?
Sure did. Shine, ask us the question and my friends and I will tell you the answer.
Okay, how can I do big stuff for God?
I obey God more each day.
Whee! Great job! Did the picture passes help?
Yes, thanks for helping us get the right ones. The muscle reminds us to grow strong for God by obeying the little things each day. Like our Bible verse says, Luke 16:10, whoever can be trusted with very little can also be trusted with much. Wah! And the bottle reminds us that acting like a baby means you aren't ready to do big stuff for God. But Shine, what about the cleanup picture pass?
Well, you have to obey the little stuff each day so God will trust you to do big stuff, right?
Yeah? Oh, I get it. Cleaning up is a little job I can do to obey each day.
That's right. And if you do it before your mom asks you to...
Wow, then I would really be showing God how strong I am for Him.
Let's pray all of our friends will grow strong for God too.
Friends, bow your heads and close your eyes. We're going to talk to God together. Dear God, thank you for trusting us with the big stuff when we obey the little stuff. Help us grow strong in you. In Jesus' name,
amen.
Hot diggity doggies, it's time to go. We'll see you next time.
For another Bible adventure.
Bye-bye, friends.
Wasn't that an awesome movie of music? God did so many miracles with Moses. And guess what? The Bible says God is the same yesterday with Moses, today and tomorrow. So God can do miracles even today and even tomorrow. So just remember that, friends. Well, next is our picture pass. And I have Emily's bag with me with some very important picture questions to ask. You want to guess what picture pass I'm going to pull out first? The baby bottle. The question is a baby strong enough to do big things for God? No, right? Babies are babies. They can't really do anything, right? Next, cleanup time. That's a cleanup bucket. All the toys are cleaned up, right? Think, what little job did Blinky and Shine do to show that they're strong? If you said cleanup, you're right. And you can show that you're strong by cleaning up before you're asked. Right? Next, the muscle. Do you have to be a grown-up to do big things for God? No, you can do big things for God even as a kid. So let me encourage you to do so, friends. Next is our Student Kids Spotlight, where we ask you to send us videos so we can get to see you on our videos. So have fun watching.
The Lord is my strength, has my song. He has given me victory.
Gentle angel turns away wrath. A harsh word stirs up anger.
Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love endures forever.
First Chronicles 16:45.
I like them all, and I didn't really have one in mind for this, so I'm just going to tell you the one that I came up with. The Old Testament and New Testament describe God's plan to bring Jesus to earth. And God's story is what brought us to being out of sin. That's it.
Great. Have God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. Mm-hmm. 2 Timothy 1:7.
I see. Yeah, 5:14. The Lord your God says to you, do not fear, I will help you.
All by myself.
Okay.
4:13. They don't know that, says to you, do not fear, I help you.
Good job.
Good job, buddy.
Teacher, and I call him Lord. And that is what I am. Bye.
Kids, I just love seeing you, your faces and hearing your voices. I want you to send in your videos to our Summit Kids Facebook page. And this week, we are asking you, how do you like to help? So show us how you like to help or tell us how you like to help. Thanks. So when our student spotlight's over, we move on to our small group story time where we break up into small groups. We retell the story, ask questions, and pray together. So friends, pray with me now. Lord, thank you for each kid watching. I ask that you would help keep them safe. Lord, that you would help them to obey in the little things so that someday they can do big things for you. Lord, I just thank you for each kid. Bless them in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, friends, now that I prayed and did church at home, I sure do feel better, and I hope you do too. Have an awesome week, kiddos. Bye. Okay, that was a little bit.